Welcome to Ocrop's YouTube channel, your world for information. Topic for the day is information security management system in a nutshell, that is based on ISO 27001:2013 international standard for information security management system. Before we get into the standard, let's see the evolution of the ISO 27001 standard. In 1992, a code of practice for security management was released. This was later upgraded in 1995 as BS7799 standard. Then in 2000, the ISO/IEC 17799 standard was released. In 2005, the first ISO 27001 standard was released, ISO 27001 2005, and in 2013 the ISO/IEC 27001 2013 was released. Like this, the standard has evolved from 1992. International standard ISO 27001 2013 was developed, designed and formulated to help creating a robust information security management system. It gives a systematic approach to manage sensitive company information. It's for the security of the information. It includes consideration of people, processes, IT systems, the physical security, environmental security, so on and so forth. And all these are handled through a systematic or a systematic risk management process. A comprehensive set of controls have been given in the information security best practices. It can help any kind of organization, whether it is big, large, super large or medium or small or any type. Even a startup, ISO 27001 standard is based on the Annex SL. In fact, this was the first standard that followed the common code for all the standards, future standards like ISO 9001:2015 and 14001:2015, so on and so forth. This is based on PDCA, and this standard has got 10 clauses identical to all the other standards following the Annex SL. There are about 14 controls, 34 control objectives and 114 control points. The 14 control areas are information security policies, organization of information security, human resources security, asset management, asset control, cryptography, physical environmental security, operation security, communication security, system acquisition, development and maintenance, supplier relationship, information security incident management, information security aspects of business continuity and compliance. All these have some kind of purpose to address the risk management. Once the 14 controls that are suggested by the standard are implemented, it helps in demonstrating commitment to the security by the organization. It also minimizes the exposure to risk and increases the commercial credibility and confidence of the customers. And it also gives assurance that the customer data is being handled in a careful way, not only just careful, it's also in a systematic way. 4 of the ISMS 27001 standard calls for identification of the internal and external issues. In fact, it's not identification, it's determination, which means you'll have to understand and analyze the internal and external issues relevant to the factors that can affect the information security management system. Also, the needs interested parties, both the internal and external interested parties, of whose needs and expectations are to be identified, and how these needs and expectations will be catered to has to be captured. There is no documentation requirement for this. However, this would constitute the risk management process of the information security management system. Determination of internal and external issues are referenced to the clause 5.3 of the risk management standard ISO 31000:2009 has to be documented, and the scope has to consider the interested parties in 4.2 and the internal and external issues in 4.1. Standard calls for a process development wherein it has to be established, implement, maintain and continually improve an information security management system in accordance with the requirements. Clause 5 of the standard calls for leadership and commitment, which means the information security policy and objectives are to be established, and they should be compatible with the strategic direction of the organization. It has to be integrated with other management process, as well as the resource required and the effectiveness has to be ensured. The communication, the direction, achieving the intended outcome, and working on the continual improvements or the other requirements from the leadership and commitment. The policy requirements have been stated in clause 5.2. 5.3 is about setting the roles, responsibilities and authorities for people in terms of managing their information security. Clause 6 is planning, and clause 6.1 is the to address risk and opportunities. Here, the information security risks are identified, analyzed and evaluated. Risk treatment process is selected and the appropriate controls are identified. The clause 6.1.3 calls for a statement of applicability with all the required controls. The formulation of an information security risk treatment plan is a requirement. Clause 6.2 discusses about the objectives, framing them and the planning to achieve them. Clause 7 lays the requirement for the resources, competence, awareness, communication and how the documented information has to be set for achieving the information security management system. Clause 8 of the standard is operation, and 8.1 is operation planning and control, which requires implementation of the actions identified in 6.1 and the objectives set in clause 6.2. Risk assessment and risk treatment planned in clause 6.1.2 and 6.1.3 are to be implemented in 8.2 and 8.3. Clause 9.1 sets the criteria for monitoring, measurement, analysis and evaluation. Clause 9.2 calls for the check part of internal audit, and 9.3 requires management review, a detailed management review to be conducted as part of the act. Clause 10.1 details the treatment of non-conformity and evaluation of corrective action, and clause 10.2 wants identification of continual improvement in the system. I hope you had a good time listening to all the classes of ISO 27001 in a nutshell. Hope to see you with some similar videos in the future. Take care. Bye-bye.